Okay, so today we'll be talking about Richard. Good old Richard. He is the youth icon for all X belongs to open source lover. The guy in his friendly neighborhood also gives him a fairly good competition. Not in being strictly open source, but going out of control.
What the hell am I supposed to do?
He started off his career as a young, beautiful, handsome guy. And then as time passed by, he started his own movement called Free Software Foundation, forming a cult of people who strictly use free and open source software and stay away from people who steal data, especially lizards. He and his movement started to grow up and people started calling him to talk on stage.
What do you want me to do? What the hell am I supposed to do?
Sit in the room.
I don't know.
Perform dance shows.
They told him, don't you ever come around here. Don't wanna see your face, you better disappear. The fire's in their eyes and their words are really clear. So beat it, just beat it.
And so on. Richard is also known for being very healthy and hygienic. He competed with great people like Linus Torvalds. Besides all of his dance skills, we have to appreciate him for what he did, giving me an operating system for free. He then created Emacs for some people to suffer and some people to get used to. Even though it went against his own laws, it still was very helpful to some YouTubers to create more tutorials. Unlike Linus Torvalds, who uses a Mac, Richard Stallman uses Linux. And when I say Linux, I don't mean normal Linux which you and I use. I mean Trisquel Linux, a Linux distribution which is literally made for open source freedom fighters. A Linux distro where you have no freedom to install any proprietary drivers or softwares through the repositories. Moving on to his main achievement, he started GNU, GNU, whatever you want to call it. It's an extensive collection of free softwares created by the Lord himself. Many applications like GIMP and so on are made by the GNU. Although the initial goal of GNU was to compete with other software suites like Adobe, Microsoft and so on, it has mostly changed into a suite of applications which just supports strict freedom, security and privacy. He was removed from GNU in the past because he seemed to be ill-treating all the employees he had. Yes, his own team removed him and then he was also reinserted back in very recently. At the present, Richard Stallman, just like his competitors, barely even code. They are now huge leaders and motivational speakers, giving motivation and inspiration to all youth of all countries. This is the part 1 of his journey. Of course, there's gonna be part 2 because this is part 1. Smash like, subscribe, 99% of you. Consider also being my Patreon. I have a lot of Patreons right now. It's definitely not zero. And I will meet you in the next video.